How's it going, everybody? It's Watering Alcoholics Reviews here, and today we're bringing you guys a new series. But we're also bringing you guys a review from Clown Shoes Brewery. This is from a new series we're doing called Perry's Picks. Now, you can get some brews at Perry's in a nice chest, singles for $1.49. It's a great deal. It's a great way to learn about new beers. And there's a huge Clown Shoes variety pack they decided to throw in the ice chest today. So I got a bunch of different ones we're going to try out.
Yep. Which one did you grab?
I grabbed the Cosmic Waffle. This is a Belgian-style IPA.
Cosmic Waffle?
Clocking in at 7%. Right? What can this taste like? It's also Belgian-style IPA.
I'm willing to bet it might taste like a waffle.
Waffle!
I have the Baked Goods Pale Ale, also from Clown Shoes.
Yes.
And, yeah.
Dude, I just seen the side of it. Look what it says.
The 12 beers of Christmas.
No wonder why there were so many of
them. Oh, it's on mine too.
Yeah, 12 beers of Christmas.
Employee owned.
That's pretty cool. Oh, there's
beer
also...
Beer without pretension.
Yes. There's also a description. Is there one on yours too? Because I'll remind if there is.
Yeah, there's one on mine too.
This might be from last year's limited release now I think about it. For the Cosmic Waffle Belgian IPA, the description reads the following. Taking a break from contemplating how toasted the perfect waffle board should be for cosmic surfing, we decided to modernize our OG Belgian IPA recipe. Izaka and Cryo Pop Pops now take center stage, dropping in alongside wheat and honey malts and a classic Belgian yeast strain. Back to toasted thoughts.
Back to toasted thoughts.
Cryo Pop Pops. I've never heard of those.
Cryo Pop Pops?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, cryo hops are great, though.
Oh, yeah.
It's been a while.
Let's see what this says. Sometimes you take your pet tardigrade? Your pet tardigrade. I don't know what the... Chester. For a hoverboard-assisted walk through the jungles of planet Marxial. Sometimes Chester takes you for a walk. However it happens, you deserve a refreshing treat when you get back home. This American Pale Ale bursts with tropical citrus notes, minimal hop bitterness, and a smooth malt body, making it a good companion for any baking experience.
What the fuck
was that story, though, dude? That was almost like a fever dream.
Pet tardigrade.
Pet tardigrade.
Let me know if you have a pet tardigrade in the comments down below.
I guess that purple thing is a tardigrade? I guess that's Chester right there, because he's definitely taking Homeboy right there for a walk. I don't know if you can see that, like... And he's on a hoverboard, too, so I'm guessing that right there is Chester, whatever the fuck that thing is.
Whatever the fuck that thing is.
But
yours is 5.5% as well, so it's a nice easy drinker.
Yeah.
Let's try it out.
Ooh. Whoa. It's actually hotter than I thought it would be.
This is very citrusy, especially for a pale ale.
And
I like
this. There's a bit of robustness on this one.
Yeah. Yep, and now we do the swap.
Shaboopy. Thanks.
Skull.
Good floralness on this one.
Whoa.
I like the citrus notes too. This is a decently flavorful pale ale. I'm surprised.
This is interesting.
Right? There's a lot of things going on with that one. This is a good, easy drinking beer from the Baked Goods.
I like that one. I really like that one.
This one I can see.
That one, immediately 10 out of 10. This one, too. I like this one because of how unique the flavor is.
It is really good.
You
can tell it's a European style beer by the taste, but then it has the robustness as well with the honey and.
It almost tastes like there's maple syrup in there, too.
Yeah, it's that honey.
Yeah,
you know, that makes it sweet.
That's nuts, dude.
That's crazy.
Yeah, so what would you give that?
I would say this one, I'd give it like a 9.5 for me. This is a bit more crisp, it would be the perfect 10. I just like that crisp mouthfeel, but the flavor is really good. It's floral, it's a bit citrusy, but mostly just good floral, and it feels really nice to drink. A perfect hot day beverage for sure.
I could go for a 10.
I'd match you with a 10 on this one if it came down to it, though. That one I do like an 8.5. Maybe an 8.
I would do a 9 because while I do like the... I do like the unique flavor of it.
Yeah.
But, you know, me personally, I don't see myself drinking it that often.
I don't either.
Now,
that's
something like this,
time.
Like, you just swap again.
For the baked goods, that's like a, that's something you can drink all the time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, easy.
Yeah, like you can come home and have a nice baked goods after a nice long day of work. And this one's more something I'd have at the end of the night, like a dessert beer almost, because of this.
Yeah, it's super sweet. Definitely something that you'd want like after dinner. You know, you're winding down, you want a couple beers, right?
Yeah.
No, that would be really good.
It's very cool. Yeah, so you say this is a 9 and that's a 10.
Yeah.
There it is.
Both great beers. Definitely check them out if you find them. And it'll be a little hard to find Tyler's Cosmic Waffle here, because it is a limited release.
Same with that one.
This one's limited
they
release
all
too.
Came from the
yeah,
same
look at that.
Pack. So this year, I mean, this might come back in 2023. There might be new ones because this is a Christmas 12 beers.
You don't do
Christmas
that in this house. I protect the metal.
So that's why that we're drinking these. But you know, 2023 Christmas is coming up, so we might see these beers again. Cody, you also tried the red ale. I got a few others that we drank off camera. The red ale was actually pretty solid. And there's also a few others that we have yet to try, including a spiced imperial stout, a quadruple Belgian style ale, and a brown ale as well. So I think there's 4 more in there, so there's going to be a few more episodes of this. And also for Perry's Picks, we're going to expand and try the other brews that are specifically in this $1.50 ice chest. You know, there's a lot of different beers to choose from in there. So, going to be seeing a lot more of these episodes. And I also put out a lot of personal episodes on the YouTube page of these Perry's Picks. So you can see both our and my solo opinion on these brews on our social media.
Yeah. And then I've had some people hitting me up asking when I'm going to start doing solo reviews as well. And I am going to be jumping back into those. It's just things are a little hectic for me right now, but just keep your eyeballs peeled.
That's
peeled. Yeah, I know. Yeah. But keep those steam balls peeled because they are coming back.
Yes.
But we want to keep this new segment that we got going on, Perry's Picks. That's going to become a new thing for us. And then what else are we doing? We're going to start doing more, what's the word I'm looking for? More Throwback Thursdays. We're going to be doing those where we dig up old reviews that we have done and we put them up and like, you know, hey,
check
them out.
Keep your steam balls peeled on the social media.
Because there are some hidden gems that you guys may have missed.
And we'll be adding more context as well, like what we thought, like what caused us to buy these beers in the first place. Because there's a lot of really cool stories about how we even got the beers that we reviewed in the first place. A lot of it's just like, hey, that looks good.
Yeah,
but there's other deeper stories for some of
us. True. This is very true. This is very true. So,
more.
That's for that. Also,
it's like
yes.
Black and white hats. We're going to get more black and white hats soon in some other designs. Keep those seam balls peeled.
And if you guys are in the Livermore area, keep your seam balls peeled. If you ever go to Perry's in Livermore, you might just see our hats up on the wall.
Yes, that's something that's still in the works. But
it is
we're looking work. To get our stuff out there to you guys more so. You can always hit us up. We still do shipping as well. We're going to charge like probably $5, maybe up to 10 for shipping. Just because like now that I've shipped a few things out, you kind of know what we're dealing with. But we'll definitely hook it up with lots of free pins, stickers, and buttons. We always got those on hand if you see us in person.
Those are always included with the shipping packages.
Always.
Even if you guys didn't order them, you're always going to get a sticker and a button.
Absolutely. Put them on everything.
Yeah, no, rock it. Put it on your car, put it on your battle vest, you know? Have fun with it. Put it on your laptop, I don't care.
Oh, yeah, dude.
You know, but until next time, my friends, I've been Wandering Metalhead.
I've been Tiny Square Gross.
And together we are the Wandering Alcoholics. And remember, my friends,
to pillage responsibly and skull.
Clink.
Keep it metal.